Welcome to another edition of Our City, Our World. Before we get started with our guest today, I just want to quick remind everyone about our dumpster day that we have here in the city of Reading. That's June the 24th from 9 to 12 noon. Neighbors can come out, you know, clean your basements out, your backyards, dump it in the dumpster. It's free of charge. We will not be taking any tires, no paint, no electronics. For those items, you can register them on our iRequest app that we have. You go on your iPhone or you can go on your Samsung phone into your app store and download iRequest Reading and just follow the instructions that it tells you to do. And we will come to your front door and pick those items up on certain days. Once again, that's Residential Cleanout Day, AKA Dumpster Day, June 24th. That's on a Saturday from 9 to 12. We will not take any paints, no tires, and no electronics. And it's free of charge. So, to get on with our show today, I have Michele Scribbick. She's from Commuter Services of PA.
Yes.
That's Michele. Michele, she is the employee outreach manager. And today's topic will be free transportation resources for our residents in Berks County. How are you today, Michele?
I am wonderful, and I'm so grateful to be here, Ryan. Thank you so much for having me, and
you're welcome.
NBC TV.
Right. Right.
Can I tell you about our program?
Yes.
I'm so glad you asked. So our program is Commuter Services of Pennsylvania. We're funded by the Federal Highway Administration, so everything we offer is free. Free transportation resources. We've been established for over 20 years. As a matter of fact, next year we celebrate our 20th anniversary in existence. We cover 9 counties, with Berks County being my focus. So here's how it works. You download our free app, Commute PA, and you would complete a confidential profile. You would list your organization, or you would list where you'd like to work. You would put in your home address and the address of where you'd like to work or where you'd like to go to school. Scatter map will appear and show you the email addresses or telephone numbers of people who live within your neighborhood, within close proximity, that are going from your neighborhood to the exact same location. So you would feel free to contact that person via email or phone and let them know, hey, can we please start a carpool? And this is the way we connect the community so that people can help each other find rides to employment or education, as long as they are over the age of 18 and reside within the 9 counties that we serve.
Okay, and can you tell our audience how does that help out our environment?
I will tell you, our mission, I'm glad you asked. I will tell you, our mission is to lessen traffic congestion and improve air quality. And what a timely subject with the smoke in the air right now, correct?
Right.
But in truth, we're trying to lessen our carbon footprint on the environment. So every person that utilizes a green commute is lessening their carbon footprint on our environment. So you're not only positively impacting Berks County, but you're making a positive impact on the global community. So everyone could do their part and do any kind of green commute. Our mission, like I said, just to reiterate, is to lessen traffic congestion and improve air quality. So our vision is to lessen our carbon footprint, and we do that by promoting green commutes. Now, Ryan, what are some of your ideas of a green commute? The obvious: walking, biking, mm-hmm. BARTA, taking the bus. Yes,
right.
Take
correct.
The bus.
Correct.
You know, support transit, but also people don't realize working hybrid, flexible, compressed work schedules, telecommuting. For those students over the age of 18 taking their classes, telecommuting, people working hybrid schedules, working part-time from work. All right, bringing your lunch to work every day is considered a green commute. Because Ryan, you're not hopping in your car and driving to go get lunch. Our vision is to take single car drivers off the road.
Okay, and how would you say that employers can benefit from the program.
Absolutely. With recruitment and retention, we can help them because there are a lot of great workers out there, but they don't have the transportation to get to work. So that is what we do. We connect the community, you, the community, so that people can help each other find rides. People who are going to the same location that live in the same neighborhood can connect and then find rides, carpool, save money on their work commutes, save wear and tear on their car, save money on parking in the city. This is a means for them to connect and find, I cannot say that word enough, connect,
right,
so that they can help each other get to where they want to go without transportation being a challenge.
So has the organization had, like, what's the success rate, but how do you find, you know, individuals that need your services?
I love that you said that. So we partner with employers and community organizations in the community, in the 9 counties that we serve. We meet with them, we find out what are the challenges, and let me give you an example. With County of Berks, City of Reading, with Jessica Wignett, excuse me, I'm saying her name wrong, but we just did their health and safety fairs. So I was able to address all the employees as they came through the fair to let them know about our program, to get them to enroll, because they can enroll as a driver or a rider. Driver meaning that if someone lives within close proximity of them, they're willing to give them a ride coming to the same location. Or they can sign up as a rider so that they're saying that they're looking for a ride. And that's what's great about our profile. Be as specific as possible, because when you download our app and you complete that, our app is matching you with people who can become potential rideshare matches. Mm-hmm.
So talk a little bit more about your app. Is it in the app store? Can it go
yes.
to the app store? Okay.
Yes, and the app is incredible and easy to navigate. It can show you, it not only helps you connect with other people, but it shows you the bus schedule, the routes, the fares, park and ride locations. It shows you walking and bike paths. Any which way you can get to work, it shows you all the free transportation resources for you to get from your home to where you want to go, whether it's to work or to pursue an education.
Okay, say, I live in Berks County.
Yes.
I live in Berks County, and there was a job in Denver.
Yes.
In Denver. Does it reach that far, your services?
Yes, it reaches everywhere in Berks County. We the people that enroll, that's the people that can help each other connect and find rides. Let me give you an example. Ashley Furniture, they've become a leader. They've partnered with us. They have me come in on a weekly basis. I start with their new hire orientations.
Okay.
I let every employee know from day one, should life happen, should you get a flat tire, should your car go in the garage, should your daughter have to use the car and you're without a vehicle, here's a way to connect with the current workforce.
Okay.
So that you know from day one, you have a backup plan in order to get to work. Or if you're like me and you're very frugal and you want to save money, you want to connect with somebody. Because how do you know that someone in front of the warehouse lives 2 doors down from somebody in the back of the warehouse? They never communicate during those breaks.
Right.
But here's a chance that our app connects them so that they can say, hey, you live 2 blocks away from me? Let's start carpooling. Let's save money. With the rising cost of everything, let's save money on gas.
Right, right. What I heard you mention Ashley Furniture. What are some other organizations in Berks County that you have partnered with?
Well, let's look at your shirt. Clean City Coordinator, Ryan. We work with the City of Reading.
Okay.
We work with the County of Berks. We work with PA Career Link. We also, as far as community organizations, thank you, Berks County Library, Public Library, because Stephanie Williams has been excellent. She's let me do a presentation to all 25 library directors so that they are well-versed about our program, they know about our program, they can refer. People who are coming to the libraries, a lot of that majority possibly may be looking for jobs. Well, guess what? They put our icon right on their computers so that when they're searching for a job, they can also search for a ride, secure transportation before they even get that job.
Okay. Can you tell our audience how they can contact you?
Yes, you can go on our website, Commuter Services, pacommuterservices.org. get on there, check out our website. We're on Facebook also, we're on LinkedIn. Get connected, find a ride, save money, and save the planet all at the same time.
Okay, okay. So, and you do like job fairs? You go out to
absolutely
job fairs.
Yes.
What other type of if I wanted to sponsor an event, right, and I wanted to give my community information, right? I can contact you. You will come
absolutely
out.
Absolutely, okay. Yes, and I welcome that. Let me say, Bill Clemens from Reading Housing Authority. Like, as soon as people hear of our organization, they'll invite me to say, "Hey, come here. You know, set up a table and be able to tell the community about." I do free presentations. I could do it via phone, virtually, in person. You name it. I'm going to pack my car. I'm going to be at your event, and I'm going to let people. My job is to educate and engage the community. And these are all free transportation resources that are available to you.
These are all free transportation resources
available to you. And can I say one more thing,
Ryan? Go ahead.
Thank you so much.
No,
my famous.
Go ahead.
I have 5 more minutes?
You can have 10. Go ahead. When you start,
What's great. Another great, since you're all about sustainability, you know, you're about a clean city, you're about our city, our world. Yes. Here's something that's great about our app. Every day when you record your green commutes, no matter what that green commute is, you could set it up as a reoccurring trip. So you don't have to go in every day and do that, record it. You could set it up as a reoccurring trip as long as you're doing it consistently. It'll record it for 3 months. In 3 months, it'll say, "Ryan, are you still taking your kids to their band practice or their baseball practice every Tuesday?" All you have to do is click yes, and for another 3 months, you'll receive all these points. Now, you know what's great about those points? Those points, you can go to our rewards program, and you can earn points to redeem for dining, for activities or services. We have over 2,000 vendors on our app that you can get discounts on. Mm-hmm. And here's another great thing about sustainability. Every time you do a green commute, on a daily basis, you can check our app. You can go to the Me page, and it'll show you, this is how many calories I burned. This is how many miles I took off the road. This is how much gas money was saved. It's incredible. For companies like DoubleTree that we work with, a global company, what they do is they have sustainability goals that they have to meet as a global company employer. So at the end of the year, I can run a report and send them a PDF that states what DoubleTree did in a year, what the employees did to better the community, to deliver a better world.
Okay, okay. Are you located in Reading?
We are based out of York, but my focus is each team member has a
An area?
Yes, mine is.
Do you have an office here in Reading?
No, I'm mobile. I will be wherever anyone needs me or wants me to be, I can be there.
Okay. Can we pull up the app, the download free app? Yeah. Pull that up on the screen for us, please. I would could you just go through the steps to download that?
I would love to.
Yep.
So download our free app, Commute PA. Step one, you just join. Step two, create a profile. Complete the profile. Make sure that you check off whether you're a driver or a rider. You can be both. If you have a vehicle and you wouldn't mind giving somebody a ride, mm-hmm. then check off both. Or if you're someone who's looking for a ride, then obviously check off rider. Make sure you list your organization. Or if you don't have one, you're just searching for a ride, that's fine also. Then you can go right to search for rides. And like I said, you would type in your home address and the address of where you'd like to work or where you'd like to go to school or where you're currently working or going to school. And that, a scatter map will appear and show you the email addresses and or phone numbers of people who live close to you that are going to the exact same location or within close proximity.
So just let me stop you for a minute.
Yes.
So I heard you say school. So this is not only for employment, it's for
school. No, this is anyone over the age of 18, if they want going to college.
Okay, college
yes.
also. So
yes.
this is for, okay.
We work
okay.
with Alvernia University, Albright, RAC, BTI.
Okay.
Yes,
okay.
for anyone over the age of 18.
Okay.
And then the last two steps are to record your green commutes. record them. You can even, like I said, you can set them up as reoccurring trips. And then the last one, get rewarded. Why not get rewarded for what you're already doing? Yes. Ryan, let me say, or John in the booth, let's say you're walking down, you walk down the Family Dollar to get your dish detergent. That's a green commute because you didn't hop in your car and drive there.
You logged that.
Yeah. Log that.
Log that.
Yes. Okay. Log. I like that. Log that.
Log that.
Log that.
I
it's going to be our new catchphrase.
Yeah,
log that.
I love the program because it also has some perks to it.
Yes.
It also has some perks. So you mentioned the points. So, you know, I think that would be a great initiative to draw people in.
Absolutely. And I love that you said that because that's what it's about. Mode shift. We want to change people's mindset. Instead of hopping in your car, get somebody else in your car. Anytime you have more than one person in your car, that's considered a carpool. That can be recorded. Log it. Log it as a green commute.
Okay. I thank you. I thank you for coming on the show. I believe that, you know, you gave us some valuable information. I myself personally, I have an event coming up, so I'll talk to you about that to have you actually have you come out, you know.
And, I'll be there.
And share,
I'll
and
be
share.
There.
Exactly. Because and my purpose in taking and wanting to take over the show was to actually give people a different perspective, a different view of our city, our world, right? Like given, it's a lot of organizations and a lot of things that's offered to our community that a lot of folk don't know about.
Yes.
Right. So that's my focus. You know, even when we talk about our environment,
yes.
Right? We talk about our environment. You know, like keeping our city clean. You know, the initiative that was handed to me by our mayor, the Adopt a Block program.
Yes.
That's like really growing. A lot of people didn't know about that in the beginning. You know, I came on the show. I came on the show, sat here, you know, and me and the mayor, and we talked about the Adopt a Block program. So the rideshare program. I have guests lined up all the way up until February of next year. Like I have a whole list, and it's not the same type of organizations. It's different organizations, you know. And the purpose is how does these organizations help with our environment?
Yes.
You know what I mean. And it's all types. You know what I mean. So. I appreciate you coming on the show. Do you have any last words?
I do have one more thing.
Go ahead. No, go.
Do
go
we
ahead.
Have time?
Yeah, we do.
So I wanted to also mention the Emergency Ride Home program. So what this is, Ryan, let's say that you and I did all of this, and we decided to carpool together. You're the driver, I'm the rider. At work, we're both offered overtime, and you are the driver, and you're like, oh, I've had enough fun today, I'm heading home. So I have to find an alternative way home. So if I've been recording my green commutes, that means I'm in the program. So if I have to find another way home with Uber or Lyft or a cab or BARTA, or I have to call a family member, because I've been recording my green commutes, that makes me eligible for the Emergency Ride Home program. What that means is when I find an alternative way home, I can upload that expense to Commute PA and get reimbursed up to $100 up to 6 times a year.
Okay.
And the reason we do that is we're removing any obstacles to someone say, hey, I don't want to carpool because I got kids and I got to get home after work, or I take care of my parents and I might have to leave for a doctor's appointment. So what we're trying to do is make it as easy as possible for people to mode shift, to mm-hmm. stop driving, you know, alone in their car, to think more green and make this a better community. Because if we all help each other out, it breaks my heart when I hear people in the community saying, oh, I pay $40, you know, a day to get to work. And I'm hearing this. People who want to work where the better paying jobs are, you know, on the outskirts of town. Mm-hmm. No one should have to do this. We have a program in place to help people connect and get to where they want to be. There are a lot of great people in the community who want to pursue employment and education. Here's the solution to when they can't, when they're facing transportation challenges. Here's what can fill in the gaps.
Right.
This can get them there. And I share your passion in making Reading our city, our world, a better place.
That's right.
So
that's
I want to thank BCTV. I want to thank John over there. And I want to make sure, Ryan, that you're doing an incredible job.
Thank you for having Commuter
Services of Pennsylvania on your show.
I appreciate it. I appreciate that. And I also appreciate you. Once again, June 24th, 2003, 9 to 12. We have Dumpster Day going on in the city of Reading. There are several places that we are placing the dumpsters. There are 10 total that we're placing around Reading. My email address is ryan.bradley@readingpa.gov. ryan.bradley@readingpa.gov. You can call me if you want to get involved, if you want to volunteer. Send me an email, and we can see how we can help you help us. That's it. Until next time, stay green.